All right, today we're going to be start working on our totes for the hydroponic area. I've taken the cross members off the top so we can get the tub out. And what we're going to be doing is we're going to be going around and marking just above this first horizontal bar all the way around with a marker. And do the same thing over on this one. This one's a little bit different, a little bit deeper, but not big deal. But yeah, we're just going to be marking this so we can pull the tubs out and get them cut. So let's mark around there, and very simple. Just like that. Now we'll pull the tubs out and we'll get them cut up. All right. We have got tubs all marked, got them pulled out of their metal frames. We marked them at the first horizontal cross member from the top. And what we're gonna do is we're just gonna cut these off at the lines. And yeah, we'll do that and get on to the next step. Just like that. Now you can use a lot of different things to cut these. I have started out with a battery operated sawzall, but it's just a tiny one, so it didn't really want to handle it very well. So I had to break out the old handy dandy electric one, which is probably close to 35 years old, still works like a charm. Now we're on to the next step. Before I forget, we're gonna go around and clean off all these edges. I got a deburring tool, I'll show you that. And we'll get that all deburred and ready to go. Okay, this is the deburring tool I was telling you about. Just nothing more than a little steel blade on the end of it that's sharpened and scrapes off anything, metal, steel, of course metal is steel, plastic, wood, does a very nice job. And all you do is just drag it across the edge and it peels that sharp edge right off of there. Gives it a nice round edge so you don't cut yourself. So we'll go around and do all these and then we'll be right back. All right, now that we've got the plastic all deburred, ready to go, we still got to clean it out and disinfect it. But we'll do that after we get all this cut. And what we're going to do on these metal frames is we're going to go and we're going to cut these supports right at the first horizontal beam from the bottom. So we cut the tubs, first horizontal beam from the top. Now we're going to cut the base, first horizontal beam from the bottom. And this is going to be our base for the top part, which all the plants and everything are going to go into. And the bottom will be for holding the water tank. So we're just going to use the same saw. I'm going to cut all these supports all the way around on both frames. And let's get going.
Thank you.
All right, there you go. We got another top or a bottom, and we got another top. Water tank's going to go in here. The pot for the plants are going to go in here. Our next step is to cut a hole in the center, because we're going to take the top of the tank, turn it upside down, and use the fill hole in the top as a drain to get down into here. So let's get that all marked out, and we'll get that going. One more thing before we cut the hole in the base of the frame. I noticed that the drain for the tank is going to hit one of these bars, so I need to remove one bar from the long end on both of these frames. Well, just on this one. The other frame doesn't have a bar there, so I got to take one frame off of here just so the drain has some place to come out. Just like that. And now we got a spot where the drain can come out. So let's get to that base and cut in that hole. All right, here is the hole that's going to go through the bottom. It is marked right through the top plug of the plastic tank. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut it probably an inch or so per side bigger, just so the I can screw the cap back on that tank to seal it off. So it's going to make some noise. It's going to take a little bit of time. So I will show you when I'm done. All right, we finally got the holes cut in there. Took a little more than I thought. There's a couple extra supports on the bottom that I had to take off. But yeah, they work really well. Let me show you why we're doing that. These are the tops of the tanks where the grow bed's going to be. And they slip. Right in like that, and what we're our drain's going to be right through the center. So just had to be able to clear it. I'll show you. There you go. Clear it for the drain to come out, and for us to be able to get this cap off of here if we need to. The next step is to set it all up in the our hydroponics area and see how it fits, and then we'll go from there. We'll see you over there. All right, here we are, all in place, put together. I elected to wait on washing out the tubs until I had everything dry fit together, just to make sure I didn't get anything inside the tanks before I fill them with water. And that's not going to be till probably next weekend, because I have run out of time this weekend. And I will get to the plumbing part of it next weekend, and I will definitely video that and show you guys how I do that. But we are ready for the next step. We got two big tanks, 250 gallon IBC totes that we picked up from Marketplace for about 60 bucks a piece, I believe. So this is going to be an awesome hydroponic system that eventually turn into an aquaponic system. And we've actually got room. We're probably going to put two more down here eventually. Two, maybe three more. We'll see how it goes. And it gives us... falling a hole out here. And it still gives us this whole side for walking and doing whatever, storing some stuff, what we need to. But we are ready for the next step, which is the plumbing, I said. And we will see you in the next video.